morning everyone. Today we'll study factors affecting population. Okay, there are mainly 8 factors affecting population. Okay, the first one is climate. The next, topography and landforms. Next is soil, water resource, availability of resource, size of the country, socio-economic factor and geographical location. Now children, the first topic is climate. So how does climate affects the population? Tell me, how does climate? Climate is very important factor in affecting population. See, the place which has a favorable climate means a moderate climate or very good climate, the population is very high there. Okay, and the place which doesn't have a proper climate, the population is low there. Okay, so the climate is very important factor because of the natural vegetation, agricultural production, industrial development. Moderate climate is suitable for human settlement. Okay, moderate climate means a climate which is neither too hot nor too cold. Topography and landforms. So the rugged mountain region or the rugged topography is not suitable for the population, for the huge population. So the landform, which is plain areas, are densely populated regions. Okay, they are agriculturally well developed. Okay, the next one is soil. Soil is also an important factor that contributes in distribution of population. Fertile soil, the soil which is very much fertile has large amount of rice, wheat, pulses, oats, barley. That's why the river valley areas are densely populated. Like in India, the northern plains of India are densely populated because of the fertile soil there. Okay, water resources is the must for the existence of mankind. Okay, so the area which has plenty of rivers, Punjab, UP, Haryana, West Bengal, they are densely populated. Okay, availability of resources, mining, agriculturally developed regions, they are industrially developed, like Chota Nagpur Plateau of India, rural region in Germany, okay, in UK, they are well developed region. The size of the country also determines in density of population. The large area, the country with a large land area may not be overpopulated when there is rapid rise in population, but an area which is not very densely populated may show a slight increase in population. Okay, socio-economic factors are also dominating the distribution of population. Economic factors like agriculture, industrial production, they are like social and political factors like healthcare facilities, okay, training and research centers, they are the factors which contributes in the population. Okay, geographical location also favorable geographical location and easy accessibility to the area, railway junction, northern towns, trade centers, nearness to sea, they all contribute in huge population, like Kolkata, Mumbai, Singapore, Silicon Valley, then San Francisco, Bangalore, they are densely populated because of the number of these regions are very densely populated because of the number of facilities provided in these regions. Okay, so children, summing up all the points, you can say that the region which has plenty of facilities, like where climate is also good, where topography is not rugged, where soil is fertile, where water resources is easily available, and where the resource is available, where the size of the country is moderate, where we have socio-economic factor, these all the things, where facilities are much higher, the population will be much higher. Okay, number is birth rate and death rate. Birth rate is also called as natality rate, and death rate is also called as mortality rate. Okay? Death rate and death rate, mortality rate, birth rate, natality rate. Okay? So what is birth rate? The rate at which births take place. The rate at which birth takes place is a birth rate or natality rate. Okay? Then crude birth rate is CBR is generally expressed as the number of births per 1,000. Okay? The number of births taking place every 1,000 individuals. So CBR is equal to BI upon P into 1,000. BI upon P into 1,000. Where BI indicates live births in a year, P indicates estimated population in a mid-year, and into 1,000. Okay? Now, the rate of birth is influenced by number of factors. The rate of birth, when the birth increases, is indicated by number of factors like fertility, nutrition, policies, social values, and culture. What is death rate? The rate of occurrence of death, okay, is called as death rate, which is also called as mortality rate. CDR, crude death rate, is expressed as number of deaths occurring per 1,000 individuals, okay, where CDR is equal to D upon P into 1,000, where D is number of deaths, P is estimated population, and per 1,000 individuals, which is into 1,000. And the death rate may be influenced by some of the factors like war, disease, technology, medical facility, nutrition. Okay. Like if we take the rate of birth in India in 2017, it is 19.01 per 1,000 individual, and death rate was 7.21 per 1,000 individual. Okay. See, you have studied about children birth rate and death rate. You have to remember what it is also called as. Birth rate is also called as natality rate, and death rate is also called as mortality rate. You have to learn the full form of CBR and CDR in its formula also. CBR is crude birth rate, CDR is crude death rate, and CBR is equal to BI upon P into 1000. CDR is equal to D upon P into 1000. It is taken out per 1000 individuals, where you have to learn BI indicates live birth and D indicates number of death, and P is the same both the sides. P is estimated population in a mid-year, and here P is estimated population in a mid-year. Okay. In the next topic, we will study about immigration and emigration. Okay.